Morning Talk SA. Thank you so much for logging on. If you're watching us on our YouTube channel on the Silver Fox Multimedia Studios, please don't forget to hit subscribe. And if you're watching us on our Facebook channel, whether it is the Champagne Talk SA or the Silver Fox Studios fan page, don't forget to hit like and share. Today I am super duper uber excited. As usual, I have my beautiful business partner, Ms. Lisa Valdez Romero, here to talk to us about the 6 steps of hosting a super successful event. Tell me about the biggest events you've ever held. I know you hold them in Vegas, which is quite a feat because she does them out of town when she's from San Antonio. She's prepping for them. So what are the secrets?
Well, first, let's have a sip.
Yay!
All right, cheers.
First things first.
Starting early.
And Happy New Year, by
Happy
the way.
New Year, definitely. Well, with Vegas Little Fitness, I've been hosting events, ladies' night out events every month. I also host a lot of bachelorette parties and birthday parties. I've done so many of them the last 7 years or so that I think I've become pretty seasoned at it.
Yeah, that's why she's the expert. So we actually bought tools.
Yes.
Matching tools.
Our planner.
And you're going to want to buy one too. And the first step, would you say, is to get a planner and plan out your monthly event for 6 months out? Is that what the rule of thumb is?
Well, to start marketing it 4 to 6 weeks before the event, if you're going to start marketing. It depends what type of event you're trying to plan, but most parties or an event, 4 to 6 weeks just to market it. You can tease them before the 6 weeks. I've marketed up to 3 to 6 months in advance just to tease it every so often, but you don't want to spam people or get people to get tired of you promoting it so much. So you can tease it every so often early, but 4 to 6 weeks is then you start hitting it harder, you know, making sure you're marketing at least twice a week. Then after about 2 weeks before the event, now you're doing it maybe almost every day.
Yeah.
And the week of the event, you're hitting it every single day trying to market
it. And now you already have your email database set up. So do you use that email database in conjunction with Facebook to market or?
Yeah, I mean, you can start off with your creating a Facebook event page. And, you know, again, 4 to 6 weeks in advance. But you can also, if you have an email list, which you should have, you should start creating through MailChimp or Constant Contact, where you can start adding all your emails that you've been collecting from all your events and send them campaign letters. So between sending your campaign letters and, you know, emailing them and Facebook ads is an amazing tool nowadays. So you can really target your market, who you want to send out, target to see your event page.
And I know that, like, for Vegas Little Fitness events in particular, you say to do one once a month because not everybody can maybe make that one if you only plan one. But if you have 6 events for the next 6 months, if somebody says, oh, well, I can't make it in January, but February looks doable, then they're already prepared to see that list of when you're going to do your events.
Yeah, I like to put like a whole year in advance of all my events. If you're going to do something consistently, you know, the same type of event over and over, which I do every month.
So you're going to use up your little planner right away. Yeah. And don't just draw happy faces.
And it's okay to change around the dates that you're going to use if it's way in advance. But that way you start giving people a heads up that you're having one on so-and-so date and so forth.
So that's the thing is you definitely want to start to let people know way in advance, 4 to 6 weeks. You want to start sending out email flyers as well as doing Facebook ads. And Facebook ads are pretty affordable. You can do like, what, $5 a day? And then you can pick out like the demographic if you want ladies, you know, between a certain age bracket in a certain zip code, city, so you don't have to hit nationwide if you don't want to. And that's the thing is that's going to be key. And then also just picking up the phone, too, and reminding. Because I know when we've had events and I talk with people afterwards, I'm like, hey, we missed you at the party. They're like, oh, I didn't even know. I'm like, really? Do you not, like, follow me on Facebook? Who are you? And they're like, no, I missed it. So pick up the phone, too. That always helps to remind people, like, hey, did you see it? Are you coming? Kind of thing. I think people like having that personal
touch. Having people just asking them to share the event page. You also want to, if you're charging for an event, you also want to create like a prepaid link. So whether you're using a PayPal on your website, or you can even create something like through eventbrite.com or Fundraiser and actually put in a nice little page together and charge online. I like to really use prepays. That way I get a good idea how many people are coming to my event. I hardly even push to pay at the door. I really push to prepay online for any event.
Yeah, that's really smart because then people are more obligated to their RSVP. Because I know sometimes I'm guilty of that. I'll see a cool event and I'll be like, oh, I'm totally going. And then, of course, my life goes crazy and the next thing I don't get to go. So that always happens. And most event hosters know that it's probably about half of the RSVPs that they see on Facebook are mm-hmm. really going to show. But if they put money down, chances are they're going to make that event. So, yeah, definitely. Okay, so then what do you say, like an hour before the event, how do they prep?
Well, actually, the day prior, I always send out courtesy reminders. So everybody, this is why I push my prepay. So everybody that prepaid online or RSVP through my email, I usually create a file on my email. And I'll start putting all the emails of all my prepays or all my RSVPs into that file. And the day prior, I send a letter, which I just copy and paste and everybody the same thing. Or unless you have your database on your MailChimp or Constant Contact. And I just give them courtesy reminders what to expect when they show up to the event, if there's anything, the attire, what to wear. just little courtesy reminders. And it makes my life so much easier at an event, especially a ladies' night out event. Because if not, your phone is ringing. You're getting emails like crazy. What do we wear? You know, what's required? How much is it? So the courtesy reminders help out a lot. So I just do that the day prior. Then the day of, people already, if they got my courtesy reminders, they already know what to expect. So everything goes very smooth. But I show up usually about, in my event at least, I do smaller events, an hour prior to set up and get everything ready. A sign-in sheet with the waiver, very important for my events. So I can start keep adding on to my database. Collecting those emails is my backbone of my business. So
yeah, definitely going to those different vendor events like the bridal shows or the different shows that come through. Usually you do get an email database as well as the ones that you collect at your booth. So mm-hmm. keep those. Don't just toss those into the trash because they didn't follow up or whatever it was. And then for Vegas Little Fitness, you've had really big events though. Like, what was the biggest event you ever hosted?
I've done stuff with actually the bridal expos. It can be overwhelming sometimes with over 100 ladies, but it's fun.
That's the thing is I'm going to start hosting my own VSF and Sexy Corset Club where I'll be integrating both. I'll have corsets hanging around so people can try them on as well as do the sexy dance lesson. So I was like, Lisa, what are the tips? So that's why I was like, you got to tell everybody who hosts all kinds of events, whether you're pushing Mary Kay or VSF, whatever mm-hmm. it is. These are tips that you can use for that. But we are looking to grow VSF as usual, and we're having another ladies' night event. When is our next ladies' night out?
January 17th is our next one.
So it's coming up. So mark your calendar. Get your calendar. Mark it out. You're done. What time are you doing it?
8:30 to 10:30 p.m. on January 17th.
So you'll show up an hour before. You'll get all the little candles, baby candles out. Mm-hmm. How do you prep?
The number one thing is the ambiance. So the lighting is very important. So I have a disco ball and make sure that's happening. I also put on music. I want the ladies to feel, you know, sassy as soon as they walk in. You know, it's for a ladies' night out. So I have the disco ball on. I have music playing, usually like Vegas type of techno type of music, just to make you feel like almost like you're in a club again, like when you were younger. You know, just then also I make sure it smells good. So sometimes I burn incense or a little candle burning just so it have a nice sexy smell. So the ambiance for me is the most important. So that's what I mostly prep for. The table covers, these little things I put bling everywhere, those very simple. You know, I put those on the little tables and so forth to give them a little Vegas ambiance is what I call it. So that's what I do. And then after the event, the following day, I actually follow up with everybody that attended. And I send them an email and thanking them for coming. And I letting them know my next ones, maybe give them a discount for attending and so forth. So.
And then that's how you build. But there's even something more exciting coming up with Vegas Stiletto Fitness. And that is
our contest. We're having a 6-week.
Because, yes, I've been having a little champagne and chocolate.
We're having a 6-week fitness contest, and you can win a trip, a vacation to Las Vegas. So all you need to do in the 6 weeks, you sign up. There is a fee for it with three different packages. With that fee, though, you're going to get a lot of incentives. So it's not like you're paying just to be part of the contest. You're actually going to get you know, material things, you know, for being part of the contest. And then once you're also going to get an actual personal coach that will follow up with you once a week just to make sure you're doing everything you're supposed to be doing, and we'll be helping you along the way and answering any questions you may have.
Then, is the coach going to come and like spank my hand? Because they're like, put down the champagne.
And then at the end of the 6 weeks, you'll take a before and after picture. So it's a transformation contest. We're not really looking at who lost the most weight. It's mostly about inches, mostly about confidence, just a transformation, what you do with your body, how you ate clean. You can do a lot in 6 weeks. It's a really good kickstart. So we don't expect we don't want you to, you know, drop a lot of weight in 6 weeks. But there could be a nice transformation that you can do to yourself in 6 weeks. And we'll be able to see that. And it'll be turning in a transformation picture along with maybe a little biography about yourself and your experience during the 6 weeks and what you did.
So they can go on, they can get sexy dance lessons for mm-hmm. free.
They will. It's also going to include, the entry fee will include the Vegas Hello Fitness website, which you'll be able to get all the videos and work out at home. You'll also be able to, you're going to get your personal training. So you get a lot of extra perks by just joining. And there's different packages. One will include your corsets as well.
Yep.
and your anti-cellulite wipes.
Yep, too. That's right. Our skin toning wipes mm-hmm. will be in one of the packages there. So you just have to go into VegasStilettos.com. Don't do the Vegas Stilettos, but VegasStilettos.com.
Actually, we actually got another domain. It's easier to remember. It's VSFnetwork.com.
Oh, thank God.
Yeah. It's going to direct you to the VegasStilettoFitness.com, but it's VSFnetwork. And go there. You can enroll there if you'd like to do the 6-week fitness challenge.
Yes. And then you actually get a voucher for 2-for-1 plane ride. And mm-hmm. you get 3 nights on the Tropicana on the actual Vegas Strip to celebrate and show off your inner showgirl. Mm-hmm. So after you've been practicing for 6 weeks, all those sexy dance VSF moves on your chair, you'll be able to like run the roost out there on the Vegas Strip and show those girls what you learned.
And you also get $500 in gambling money.
Gambling.
Not cash, but casino chips.
But if you win with those chips, you get to keep that money.
Yes.
So that's exciting. Mm-hmm. So get your lucky fingers mm-hmm. out, blow your kisses to all the yellow lights.
And if you win, you actually get, you do get $100 cash, basically to pay back, you know, if you enter the $100 fee to get in, you get $100 back, aside from everything else that you're winning. So it's going to be pretty interesting how many people are going to enter this.
Yep, and you can compete worldwide, so you do not have to be local to us to be able to receive any of the benefits. You'll be able to log on, get your sexy dance lessons, get your calls, and also, you know, just get motivated, inspired. And that's the one thing about doing VSF. I know I've started practicing again, and it's like, wow, it's a way different fitness. It's a woman's fitness taking the world by storm. So you definitely want to log on to VSFnetwork.com and enter that weight loss challenge and then be able to go celebrate with your friends mm-hmm. on the Vegas Strip and come up with your inner showgirl name. Mine is always Lola. So yeah, don't forget to get your planner. Don't forget to go on to VSFnetwork.com. Don't forget to do the 6 steps before you host your event, whether it's a VSF event or your own business event. Listen to Lisa, make sure you log on, and we'll see you next time. Happy New Year.
Happy New Year.
Bye.